Ho, ho, hola mi gente!
Hey!
Hey! Guys, so apparently we need you leaders for the new investors or investors that are left holding a bag. This on SBRT did his run, turned into GREE. A fiasco happened where just the big investors and people that were hedging, according to me, I don't know, allegedly, were able to sell most of their positions. And I don't know if they were able to cover, but we were not able to touch it. There was a stop on buying and selling, and it was very advantageous on their part to do all that and literally just destroy. I made a video, like a short video about it, how it went from $91 all the way down in less than minutes to 70, and then it just kept on going down. 12 something, the ticker symbol GREE, as better known as SBRT, just crashed all the way down to 32 something, below $33. If people are confused about this, it's because for some reason, the shares are just 0.1.15 of a GREE shares. Any SBRT share is a decimal of what it was before. And it was playing ping pong, or pong, because it was going up and down for about 2 days, and now people are not even talking about it. And when the Zip Trader, very good guy, people that are very successful with their DD, and other people like Michael Kors and all those people, they are telling you that this is very risky and all that crap and everything. Yes, all these stocks that we're investing in, including AMC, GME, are risky. When we inject FUD, even if it's in the best, you know, on the best interest, even if it's for the best interest of the investors, but as a YouTuber, you don't apply the same fear, and instead you start saying it's not the same, like, well, what are the fundamentals? It doesn't really matter. These plays are not fundamental plays. And when you see people like Kors and other people that are doing live trading, and instead of holding, they literally just leave. You have to understand that people see you as the leader of the pack. Guys, don't follow me or any of these people as if they were the leader of the pack, because it's your money. You should not be playing with your money just thinking that the other guy has the best interest on you. Now, other people that were not able to be watching Kors or other people that we were at work at that time, we were not able to play the plays that they were playing, we were stuck with a big bag. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm gonna tell you right here, I was holding a bag for about like $100 loss, whatever, but I got that money back by swing trading it, sort of make that money back, because you have to pay 37%, I think, in New York for every gain that you make. But I reinvested it again. I went against my own motto. Once you make that gain, get out of there and just watch on the sidelines. Don't stay there. Once you make your gains, it doesn't matter if it's doubling or $2 per share. If you make $2 per share and you had like 97, that's close to $200 that you made on a play. You know what I mean? Extra. So where am I getting with this? If you need a cheerleader, I'm going to tell you, it has a low float. GREE still has a low float. If you're going with the fundamentals, then all of the plays that you are doing that are supposed to be short squeezes, all of those plays also have to have that applied to them. You know, if you go on by the fundamentals, you shouldn't be playing those plays because of for the same reason that you're not playing GREE. But GREE, as BBIG, they have a very low float, very high short interest. Short interest. And it's dying. So right now it's on sale. You could get that for sale. If you were to convert how much it went down, when SBRT was still SBRT, it went down all the way to $10.90, I believe. Correct me if I'm wrong down here. Again, I have 3,000 subscribers and only like 15 views. And 10 of those views are me trying to fix the video that I made. Share the videos, please. If you are a GREE backholder, which if we actually apply the same rules to this play as AMC and GME, this one can move a little faster, way faster. And you don't even have to make the same amount of money. You could actually play this game, play. You could play this one multiple times until you recover your money. Or if you actually want this thing to squeeze, you could just hold it. Because they're still, if you see it going down, they are still shorting this stuff. And people are selling out too. So it's not just the hedgies. It's actually people freaking out, thinking that they can buy back in. If you already lost two-thirds, I know in my other video I say three-thirds, which makes no fucking sense. If you already lost two-thirds of your gains, why would you pull out now? Why would you actually do that? I'm working, and I've already put money on SDC. SDC is actually going down too. They are, and what I mean, the people that are watching that are not our people, the non-retailers, they are watching. They're really smart people, and they will attack everything that you are advertising here on YouTube. They are watching. So GREE is not a dead cat. If you let it die, it will be on us. But the thing is, it has a very low float. You could actually hear it from the Zip Trader. Other people have said the same thing. And with the illegal shit that they did, excuse my language, the illegal stuff that they did where they were just destroying this and not allowing the traders to pull out or to sell or whatever on time, because it was a lot of people lost money on this. So Spartans, we need to go back into this. I'm still gonna put money on this. I don't have any money today. I get my money on Wednesdays. But if I had the money, I would have put all my money on GREE. I'm not telling you what to do. I'm saying what I will do. It's on sale right now. You could actually move this very quickly. And we are a lot of Spartans there. But nobody's talking about it. It's just died out. Nobody is literally talking about this. They're letting it die out. They are investing on BBIG. Like I said, BBIG, AMC, GME. GME, it's actually a little bit harder to get because it's too high of a price for one stock, you know? This one, you could probably make, this is my opinion, not if you believe that I'm a good investor or advisor, come on, I'm practically a hobo. But if you have conviction on this play and you have more people investing on this and holding, you could literally make multiple plays on this and then get out, make your money back. Even Fintel told you this is still a good play even after the merger, because it's not about the fundamentals. Don't let this be the next MMAT. And MMAT is actually moving up. They are attacking it. It went down all that way to 480 or 489, something like that. And people are just buying it back up. Understand that? I'm not moving anything from AMC. If you think that AMC is a sure thing, what's different about GREE? What is different about it? It's the same thing. I'm going to repeat myself over and over. It's the same thing. This has been 13 minutes of me rambling about GREE. And yes, I'm going to start investing again on it. God bless you guys. This is Sir. This has been Sir Nuenegra. And I really do love you. The whole stock market is down. So don't be afraid of it. Ride it. Buy the dip. Hold by the dip. Stop playing with options. I don't know why people are so enamored with options. They know how to manipulate those things too. They are watching us, guys. God bless you guys.
Serena Negra, that's me.